glitch into Midgard. God damn it, he just... Yeah. Coward. I just wanted to see Vinland Saga. It would have been such a fun game. Such a fun game indeed. But yeah, well, you're in for a standard map, which is Midgard. The gods are going to be Set and Zeus. Yeah, they were preset before the map even was coming in. And Hagrid is going to be using this opportunity to actually get some vision across the map to see where he needs to place his fishing economy. And it's going to be coming to the top, into the corner of the map, which is the wrong corner because you can see this one fish in there. One huge fish. So we're having a bolt on one villager. Right now I kind of question if maybe it wouldn't be better to cast the bolt on the Pharaoh to basically screw up the empowerment. I'm not entirely certain that's going to be up to Egyptian players if they actually think losing Pharaoh in the early game is going to be a bit bigger problem than losing the villager. I'm not really certain because I'm not really expert with Egyptians at all. But looking at this dock, it should be alright with the 3 and 3 in here, but still the corner is absolutely sad. Absolutely nothing in there. But it's not like it, the bottom one is better, so it's he didn't really have all that much of a choice in there. But of course his opponent is having much better choice. He's having like now 3-some in there. 3-some on the top, not great, but he's having absolutely glorious bottom side. And if he does discover this and goes for this corner of the map, then, well, could be... could be quite a good economy for him and a good way to somehow win the game. Of course, they are spawning with just 2 berries both. So they're gonna be having significant problems with food in this game. They're probably gonna be switching into some walruses at the top, maybe into the deer at the bottom. If he has discovered it yet, which I think he did, because Kataskopos is already coming forward back home from this position. So I kind of think that he at least could have seen a few deer from this patch, so should be alrightish for him. Otherwise, for the red player, who is going to be finishing with the berries also pretty soon, I'm not sure, but he does have the caribous on the left. He does have even more deer on the right side, so he's going to be moving in here. He also potentially does have some walruses, and of course, as I said, he's going to be converting a few of them to work for his cause, and may, much more than anything, also die for his cause. So second dock coming up for this threesome for a bit more efficiency. Then he's probably going to be continuing with another one in between those doubles. As this is a double threesome, very nice one of salmons in there. Gonna be helping him with the economy. And well, right now blue looking forward to get the threesome in there. So far not coming to the bottom, but I'm definitely hopeful for him that he's gonna discover the bountiful sea that is waiting for him in here with some salmons, some perches. And even apparently some orcas that we cannot really get it from. Yeah, well, killing orcas is not really any kind of fun, as they are damn clever and they might just as well try to hunt you. So, not a good idea back in the days, I guess. So, walrus is already being captured in here, so apparently he did miss the deer at the bottom. So that also means that he probably did miss the relic, which is for faster myth unit special attack recharge time. Yeah, well, for Zeus, why not? It's not bad. Could be actually quite good for him. And better human soldier pierce armor. That's a very good relic for anybody. And of course, Red will be picking that up as soon as possible for himself. So second dock in here. Yeah, well, in the big emptiness. Yeah, so many hopeful boats, and so far nothing, and nothing, and nothing, and finally, he finds at least this. So unfortunately, he's choosing the wrong side. Well, he's having the villages in there, so he was hoping that it's gonna be a bit better. But yeah, it's not the same as for the opponent, who has already discovered the sad state of the waters in the top side. But he, of course, is also discovering the much better state of the waters coming through the bottom, and that is... good news for him, good news for his early economy, and for his early boom, as he's already thinking about advancing into the next age. Well, of course, we are at 4.5 minutes almost, so it's gonna be actually pretty late-ish advance. It's gonna be like 5:40. That's very late. It's very late for him. Of course, BoIt is probably gonna be advancing a bit sooner. Yeah, he has probably clicked somewhere here, maybe. Maybe, could be, We're gonna see a few seconds, but I'm kind of thinking so that it definitely could be the case, as he's right now we are moving into more woods and he's gonna be trying to go for the... Is he gonna place the dog here? It almost seems like that he will. Or maybe he just placed it right next to the opponent, but yeah, he definitely has to hope that he doesn't go all that far behind and far away, because there is a trap waiting for him here. Oh, he's gonna run into it. He's gonna run into a trap, and that's... Oh, just now stopping. Not anymore, priest. Apparently right about now. Yeah, the priest wasn't watching, but Boyd was, and he just basically noticed that there's a problem waiting, and it's going to be... Oh, Athena Rush. Mm-hmm. A funny one. He's unfortunately in a pretty bad spot. Basically placing the military academy here is like the same as placing it inside his base. It's the same far away. I don't exactly understand why he actually did this. Because he should have scouted by the Cataskopos already. And he should know where his opponent is. But it just doesn't make any sense whatsoever. I mean, this is literally as far away as from the base. So, I don't get it. I really don't get it. There was probably some kind of thought that he was hoping that he can get into the docks a bit sooner. Well, yet again, that's not such a huge advantage, but probably that's the thought, because I cannot really see any other thought behind it. As the village is apparently gonna survive, he's gonna lure the walrus behind him, but yeah, the walrus is just now gonna be switching to the left and probably gonna die to all those gold villagers pretty soon. Unless he actually turns away, turns back the same as Boyd's villager, which, well, probably not the case all that much. So shifting sense, stealing 3 gold villages, is of course pretty important, right next to the TC and tower, so that's going to be all 3 of them dead. Yes, they will be all 3 dead. So nicely played by the set, and of course getting the armory up, so apparently not that interested in the classical fight just now, even though he's fighting for it. The hoplites are definitely gonna be helping getting rid of the dogs a whole lot sooner. And even though he does have poor stain, and he was hoping that the water economy is going to be coming for him quite alright, wouldn't be really all that certain right now anymore. With the Triremes coming forward through all the water, finally some dogs coming to the left side as well to discover a bit more fishies on the left for Boyd. It's not looking really all that great right about now for Red. Because of course some extra hoplites are gonna be coming up, and once they are in enough numbers, there is not going to be any protection for the dogs whatsoever. So poor stain there, unfortunately for Boyd still not. He's still having normal nets on the fishing boats. So he hasn't really upgraded into the next stage. As apparently, I'm kind of thinking that the animals are aiming for actually getting rid of the military academy. Here it's going to be a bit hard to actually keep it standing. Even though the animals are not having such a huge attack, it's still gonna come down in about a minute or whatnot, as those hoplites are alive, potentially could be getting onto the docks. But with all of those cabinets already prepared and the Triremes in not really enough numbers, he's probably gonna have to use restoration sometime soon, it seems like. Yeah, well, the hoplites trying to get into the houses, which I think is not a bad idea. Actually coming into the houses sooner rather than the docks is a good idea, because it will block the building capacities of Hagrid quite significantly, and also block his villages for a bit longer, because placing houses, or rather building houses, is not that easy. And not that fast, especially. So restoration off, right now is going to be basically down to proper numbers. As the military academy is almost dead, still plenty of dogs to kill, and apparently even some barracks are coming up. Oh well. Oh well, oh well, oh well. Now this is always going to be pretty tough for Boyd. And I'm not entirely certain that he should be still engaging, because of course the military production is much closer for Hagrid, and he's just gonna be having so much more boats than at any time Boyd can be having, that it just doesn't make any kind of sense for Boyd to engage in equal battles, because they're not gonna be equal for much longer. And yeah, I kinda think he should be really running away, trying to make some kind of decoy through the bottom, send like 2-3 boats through the left side into the bottom, and then try to lure the enemy into making a mistake, like dividing the army, sending it somewhere else, and yeah, just be annoying through that, because you will be controlling the waters, and it will be just a bit better for you. Anyway, another dog coming up, apparently. As hoplites are still alive, trying to somehow be annoying as much as possible, as another backup dogs are coming up. Basically, right now, going to be denying the idea that BoIt was having. Well. Moving forward. Oh, nice reinforcements. Nice reinforcements just now coming in. Cabinets. Well, what I kind of think right now is a bit of a shame is that Hagrit actually doesn't have copper shields. Because he does have the armory. He has already built it quite a bit sooner. So there should be an opportunity for him to research it. It's like 150-150, so basically like about two boats. More or less. And I kind of think in the longer battles and in the interims that he's having between the engagements. Oh, nice Kaiten. Oh, somebody wasn't paying attention, Hagrit, right? He definitely wasn't because he's right now paying attention to this. And he's gonna be... Oh, this was horrible for him. He might be even significantly hampering his water efforts by trying to go here. But at the same time, of course, it's gonna be meaning that about 10 villagers are not gathering wood right now for BoIt, which is a huge outage. Huge outage indeed. And it's going to be up to Jason to be the hero that we need. But, yeah, well, BoIt deserves him. Neft is up. I would cast it right off. I would cast the ancestors right off in here. Before he's having Odysseus. And before Jason is actually free to do anything that he wants, which is right now gonna be the case. Yeah, I kind of think that he should have been casting it. Oh, good idols. Where did he actually place it, goddammit? I need to move around. Yeah, my scroll wheel is actually all screwed up. Oh, this is a sad... This is even sadder picture than all of those guys not doing anything through the march from the bottom. Yeah, and unfortunately, BoIt is probably not gonna notice because they are not listed as idle, those villages. So that was pretty sad. Yep, that was absolutely horrible for him. But anyway, right now with the heroic age, right now we are gonna be seeing some war barges, and that's not good news for BoIt because he is not in the heroic age. And of course, he doesn't have any kind of chance against Siege Bulls yet. Well, Pentaconters are so far away from him, it seems like at this stage. Even though he probably clicked through Heroic Age some half a minute ago. It's still gonna be pretty late, but also could be still pretty fast enough. Pretty fast enough still. Oh, I'm going to be coming for Fortress to steal a TC, or rather steal a TC, secure the TC in there with the gold mine. But yeah. The Pentaconders could be coming up, Skillas as well, and apparently it's going to be Skillas for him. He is gathering favor not really that diligently and that enthusiastically. Just one girl is right now praying in there, but still could be enough. As Hagrid is having at least some army, it's going to be apparently some Axemen, but against horses, yeah, that's not a good idea. Not a good enough idea. Well, of course the Hydra is gonna help. I would be definitely welcoming some extra Pentaconters, right exactly here. Going to be coming there into the battle pretty soon, as some Giraffes with some Chariots are trying to find something to kill, but will they succeed? Not entirely certain. The Migdal on the left is already going to be producing more units, and of course some Siege Towers from the Siege Works are going to be supporting that. We've taken the TC in the middle, second TC is also being captured by the opponent, and it's going to be even a third one for Hagrid. So yeah, quite a lot of economy coming up. And also, all around map control. So yeah, right now Hagrid is going to be discovering potentially that there's already a fortress by BoIt, which is of course going to help quite immensely, because he can do some sneaks like by Petroboli into the bottom, into this TC. Might be quite easily happening in there. As we are still pursuing the siege boats by the Skilla, which is kind of alright, I guess. It's kind of alright. He said he's gonna scout plenty of map, the same as Hagrid, but still Those boats cannot really stop, because if they did, then the Scylla would be killing them fairly easily. In the meantime, some arrow ships are in the enemy economy, as these have been even sold them for already. But he's gonna lose plenty of economy, because apparently he's not fighting for the water anymore. Yeah, he probably is just giving up on it. Can see a bit more engagement right now by BoIt in there. And he is readying himself for a bit of attack, as the spearmen are gonna be the unit of choice from the barracks, finally. That's a bit better than the axemen in there. And he is going to be attempted, but at the same time, this is exactly where Hagrid wants to actually push forward. And since, of course, this is going to result in ancestors most definitely, yep. And the bronze is up, because he needs to respond to this, as he needs to fight this at all costs. Unfortunately, the siege tower is going to make sure that the TC is gone, and that also results into pretty tough battle, and even the bronze is not really gonna save this, especially since the Odysseus is not battling against the ancestors. Yeah, he's battling against the spearmen, unfortunately. Only Jason was doing his job, killing the ancestors. So yeah, unfortunately Odysseus paid with his life for it, but Heracles is up to basically make up for him yet again, and he is a pretty good dude. He is having 480 hit points, quite good armor, even though 25% for melee is not all that much, it's still not bad, and he can deal some decent punishment with his big 12 attack and big club as well. So siege tower is gone, and Odri is still coming up. Oh, two are coming up with four elephants. Well, he definitely needs to hurry up. He's gonna be making it in time, because he's having enough villages in there. But does he have some masons already? No, he doesn't. In that case, he's gonna lose it promptly. He's actually gonna lose it as soon as he put it up. Yeah, that's gonna be just a bit too strong. Right now, Odysseus is not going to be the hero that we need. So, yeah, good investment. Good idea by BoIt. But unfortunately, it's gonna be for absolutely naught, as two elephants with two siege towers are gonna be putting it down fairly soon, and they're going to be continuing their way into the fortress as well. So unfortunately this was backfiring for BoIt quite significantly. I'm not entirely certain if he can actually come back from this, because he has invested a bit more into the water than was probably needed. You can see he's not even continuing forward, and yeah, BoIt is recognizing that this game is gone. He's just gonna be way too late to actually come back with some more reinforcements, and that means that we are actually gonna be tied. So Hagrid taking the set against Zeus, and well, we are tied after 6 games. Well, let's go into the post game. That's gonna be resulting to Hagrid. Winning everything but economy, but just a difference of 47 points in there. Otherwise, it was quite similar. Not a big difference in there. Even though Hagrid wasn't efficient at all, 119, 74 killed, as opposed to 82 and 90, still resulted into victory for him. Yeah, some extra missing upgrades. Same population, but unfortunately for Hagrid, it was a bit, or rather unfortunately for BoIt, Hagrid had it a bit better allocated. GG.